welcome once again to Travel in Chinese. My name is Mark Rosewell, otherwise known as Dashan. You know, over this series, we've covered a lot of ground in China. We started in Beijing and we visited cities in eastern China like Shanghai, Suzhou, and Hangzhou. We went to Yunnan province in southwestern China. We saw the ancient capital of Xi'an in western China and went further west to Xinjiang. We went to the far northeast to Harbin, and we even went to Inner Mongolia and many other places. Well, today we're in southern China in the famous scenic area of Guilin. We pick up today's lesson where we left off last episode in front of Xiangbishan, Elephant Trunk Hill.
我刚才听那个叫山的人说，这座象鼻山还有个故事，这是怎么回事啊？哦，那个故事啊，可有名了。啊，原来你们都知道，快点说说吧。传说这座山本来就是一头真的大象，它的主人是天上的神仙，一天这头大象碰巧来到桂林，觉得这儿的风景太漂亮了，就一直站在漓江边看。
而他的主人啊，想让他回到天上去，他就说什么也不走，神仙很生气，就用宝剑啊把他杀死了。你看那山背上啊，还多出一小块的，大家都说那是宝剑的剑柄。
啊，是吗？哎，我看看。
哦，挺像的。哎，桂林的山都像象鼻山这样有故事吗？
在我们桂林有三座山特别出名，分别是叠彩山、伏波山和你刚才看到的象鼻山。
这三座山可以说是座座都漂亮，至于故事嘛，
啊，还有什么故事？
至于故事嘛，就要靠你们自己去找了。<笑>
行了，小顾，你就别卖关子了，还是告诉他吧。
关于桂林山水的故事其实特别多，我们何不坐船顺漓江而下，一路上让导游把所有的故事都告诉你们。
哎，太棒了！啊，我回国以后一定要把这些故事告诉我的朋友。
是。
好。
哎呀，这里真是山清水秀啊！
我有一种人在画中游的感觉。还有那么多故事，这么多传说。
对，
还有什么手套山，还有望夫石，走马跨山。
对，
你看，他都入迷了。
等一会儿下了船，还有更好的风景等着你们呢。 哎，太好了，
太好，太好。
OK, let's go over the dialogue part by part. Mike has heard that there's a story about the Elephant Trunk Hill. He asks, 这是怎么一回事啊? What's that all about? In other words, tell me the story. Here, 回 is used as a measure word, a chapter, the way stories are divided up. So this is like saying, tell me how this part goes. 怎么一回事? Tell me the story.
哎，麻烦你给我们照张相好吗？
好，来，啊，三，好，好，谢谢，谢谢。
哎，我刚才听那个照相的人说，这座象鼻山还有个故事，这是怎么回事啊？哦，那个故事啊，可有名了。啊，
原来你们都知道，那快点说说吧。
The story is that this hill used to be a real elephant. 一头真的大象，它的主人是天上的神仙。 Its master was a god or spirit, 神仙 from heaven. It just so happens, 碰巧, the elephant came to Guilin one day. 巧 is a coincidence, 碰巧, by coincidence. It just happened. 碰巧来到桂林, came to Guilin by coincidence. Its master wanted it to return to heaven. 他却说什么也不走, But it didn't matter what the master said, the elephant would not move. Here, 却 is used as but or regardless. 却说什么也不走. He wouldn't move regardless of what the master said. In a fit of anger, the master killed the elephant with his 宝剑, sword. Swords are called 宝剑 because double-edged swords used to be extremely valuable and rare. 宝 means treasure. Now, 宝剑 just refers to any sword. 你看那山背上还多出了一小块。 If you look at the elephant's back, on the back of the mountain, there's an extra piece or a piece sticking out. 多出一小块. They say that this is the handle, 剑柄, of the sword. 柄 is a handle, 把柄, something that you grab hold of. 剑柄 would be the handle of a sword.
传说这座山本来就是一头真的大象，它的主人是天上的神仙。一天，这头大象碰巧来到桂林，觉得这儿的风景太漂亮了，就一直站在漓江边看。
而他的主人啊，想让他回到天上去，他却说什么也不走。神仙很生气，就用宝剑啊把他杀死了。哎，你看那山背上啊，还多出一小块的，大家都说那是宝剑的剑柄。啊，是吗？哎，我看看。Not
all mountains have a story behind them, but there are three famous mountains in Guilin. 分别是叠彩山, they are the folded brocade hill, 湖泊山, wave subduing hill, and 象鼻山, Elephant Tusk Hill. 分别是 is used before a list to indicate that you're going to name or list things one by one. For example, we could say, 学校里有五位老师,他们分别是, there are five teachers in the school, and they are, then you go on to name them one by one.
哎,桂林的山都像象鼻山,这样有故事吗?
在我们桂林有三座山特别出名, 分别是叠彩山、湖泊山和你刚才看到的象鼻山。这三座山可以说是座座都漂亮。至于故事嘛，啊，还有什么故事？至于故事嘛，就要靠你们自己去找了。As
for the stories behind these mountains, 至于故事嘛，就要靠你们自己去找了。That's up to you to find for yourself. 至于 is like speaking of or as for. 至于故事。 As for the stories, 黄仁浩 says, 你就别卖关子了。Don't leave us in suspense. 卖关子 is a way of storytellers will always tell a part of the story and leave you hanging on a cliffhanger. 卖关子 is to keep people guessing. Previously, we covered the use of 不如 to make a suggestion. Well, here we see the term 何不? Why not? Why don't you? If you want to hear all the stories, 我们何不坐船? Why don't we take a boat trip? 顺漓江而下, down the Li River. 一路上让导游把所有的故事都告诉我们, and ask the guide to tell us all the stories along the way.
行了，小顾，你就别卖关子了，还是告诉他吧。关于桂林山水的故事其实特别多，我们何不坐船顺漓江而下，一路上让导游把所有的故事都告诉你们。哎，太棒了。
Let's take a moment now to talk a little bit more about the scenery in Guilin. Situated majestically at the southeast of Guilin City and along the west bank of the Li River is Elephant Trunk Hill, Xiangbishan. This is regarded as a symbol of Guilin's landscape. Resembling an elephant leisurely sucking water from the river with its long trunk, this hill has been known as Elephant Trunk Hill for hundreds of years. The hill towers 55 meters above the water, measures 108 meters in length and 100 meters in width. Between the trunk and the legs of the elephant is a cave in the shape of a full moon, penetrating the hill from side to side. People call this the moon over water cave. At night, the scene of the waves in the moonlight is exceedingly enchanting. On the walls in and around this cave, over 70 inscriptions from the Tang and Song dynasties were found, praising the beauty of the hills and waters nearby. Halfway up the hill lies another cave, which also pierces the hill and serves as the eyes of the elephant. There are several hills to explore in the area immediately around Guilin, like the Fubo Shan, the wave-subduing hill. Here you can see a fine view of the city below, as well as a huge rice pot from the temple that's large enough to cook rice for 1,000 people. Other great views of the city can be had from Folded Brocade Hill, Bie Tai Shan. Of course, all of the hills in this area have names. Many feature temples and cultural relics, and many are just a nice place for a leisurely hike or a stroll. Now let's take a moment to go over a few of the language points in more detail. For example, 碰巧, it just so happens, or luckily. 我碰巧买到了一张打折的机票. I was lucky to be able to buy a discount ticket. 我碰巧买到了一张打折的机票. Here's another example.
我去上海开会的时候碰巧见到了我的老同学.
It just so happens I ran into one of my old classmates while attending meetings in Shanghai.
我去上海开会的时候碰巧见到了我的老同学.
Let's see how they used 碰巧 in the dialogue.
传说这座山本来就是一头真的大象，它的主人是天上的神仙。一天，这头大象碰巧来到桂林，觉得这儿的风景太漂亮了，就一直站在漓江边看。
Here's another language point. 分别, separately. This is often used to list items one by one, as in respectively. For example,
这个问题我分别问了几个人，答案都不一样。
I asked several people this question one by one, but the answers were always different.
这个问题我分别问了几个人，答案都不一样。
Here's another example. 他今年去过三个国家，分别是美国、英国和法国。 He's been to several countries this year, to three countries this year, respectively, America, England, and France.
他今年去过三个国家，分别是美国、英国和法国。
Let's go back and see now how they used 分别 in the dialogue.
在我们桂林有三座山特别出名，分别是叠彩山、伏波山和你刚才看到的象鼻山。
Now let's do a little bit of substitution with a language point that we came across in today's dialogue. That's 何不? Why don't we? This is a way of making a suggestion. For example,
今天是周末，我们何不一起去郊外野餐?
Today is the weekend. Why don't we go together to the countryside for a picnic? 郊外 would be outside of the suburbs, the area around a city, the countryside.
今天是周末，我们何不一起去郊外野餐?
Okay, let's try some substitutions now with this 何不?
既然不愿意和他去旅游，你何不早说?
既然不愿意和他去旅游，你何不早说?
今天天气那么好，我们何不一起去爬山呢？
今天天气那么好，我们何不一起去爬山呢？
One thing you'll notice about traveling in areas of natural scenic beauty in China is that many of the places have been given names and there are stories or fables, 传说, told about them. We can say of these mountains, for instance, 他们分别都有故事, they each have their own respective stories. When you get to a place that has a story behind it, you should always ask, 怎么一回事? How did it happen? Tell me the story. Tell me how this one came about. The stories help to add an extra dimension to the natural scenery. Well, if you thought the scenery in this episode was beautiful, wait till you see what we have in store for you next episode when we go down the river to the town of Yangshuo. We'll see you then on Travel in Chinese.